hydrocarbon name itself difference. But there are so many projects are going on here, conventional and unconventional oil exploration methods. The normally conventional method is crude oil and gas, natural gas exploration. The unconventional methods are shale gas and oil production, tight gas production, gas hydrates, like that coal bed methane project. These are mentioned as unconventional method, because in conventional method, there is a vertical borewell up to the level of, for example, in Cauvery Delta, feasible for up to 6,000 feet enough for that. They put a vertical borewell and place the borewell pipe on the layer of crude oil and natural gas. On pressure mount on the gas and oil, it artificially it's come out from that place. That is natural gas and crude oil exploration method, conventional method. But unconventional method, for example, shale gas and oil production, there is a methodology used internationally, that is hydrofracking method. The hydrofracking method, which was the worst method for environment, and it banned in most of the European countries, and one of the major producers of shale gas, USA. In USA itself, most of the provinces, they banned the hydrofracking method. Particularly in the year 2014, New York banned that project. That New York mayor mentioned about that, that due to so many multi-stage hydrofracking conducted on New York and nearby places, tremors are identified in New York City. So that they banned the hydrofracking method. That method include in shale gas and oil production and tight gas production, and these are all unconventional method. In this new policy, they issue single license for conventional and unconventional method. We are very much afraid of that. In Cauvery Delta, the population of Cauvery Delta is more than nearly 1 crore people are available here. They are based on agriculture, and the agriculture based works along going on here. In 2010, the project CBM introduced here, there is a afraid among the people. Now, the unconventional methods already tried by ONGC and asked a public hearing for them is still pending. Now, the new policy introduced one more, say with one more salient features, that is OALP, that is Open Acreage Licensing Policy. That is, with the available data of 2D and 3D at DGH, companies identify their unallotted areas and expression of interest made by them. On the basis of expression of interest, the action will be taken place. As per the new guidelines, OALP, Open Acreage Licensing Policy, first round finalized on last October itself. In this, all over India, there are 50 blocks are identified and comes to an action. In that, the major areas allotted to the Vedanta, that is more than 40 blocks are allotted to the Vedanta. In this, in Tamil Nadu concern, according to 3 in 55, 2 allotted to Vedanta and 1 allotted to ONGC. That is, shallow seashore allotted to the Vedanta. Regarding ONGC, they allotted in the fertile lands of Kadalur and Nagapattinam district areas. In this, the single licensing also applied. They can take either crude, shale or gas hydrate or tight gas. Anything else they can take. This is the formula. Apart from this, there are so many nomination and allotted action blocks in Cauvery Delta before 2015. Mostly they are run by ONGC, exploration and production are going on there. In 1st August 2018, Central Cabinet take a decision to enhance the facility of single licensing to the pre-2015 allotted areas itself. On that basis, now ONGC identify a place which is lie in Thiruvarur and Nagapattinam district, that is Periyakudi block, and another block, Bhuvanagiri block, which is comes under the Kadalur district. In these two blocks, they apply environmental clearance for the tight gas production. They mentioned in their pre-feasibility report that the tight gas project is going on along with the hydrofracking. For hydrofracking method, they put an agreement with Blade Energy Corporation, it is US-based concern, for hydrofracking actions. These are all the problems here. Now, this is the fertile land. There are so many issues are going on regarding the Cauvery water in Cauvery Delta. Because international, as per international standard, we are the lower barrier. We have every right to get water from the upper level. But as politically, as legally, we are put in trouble for continuous years. So that the agriculture in Cauvery Delta, once based on Cauvery water, now depend on the groundwater itself. So, the depletion of groundwater is every year going on because of the most agriculture work. But at the same time, if the projects like unconventional methods are introduced here, they need for hydrofracking, they told in their papers that it need multi-stage hydrofracking. That is, in single well, suppose if they are not satisfied or production is not satisfied in single hydrofracking, they are to do more hydrofracking works. In international standard, they mentioned that for each hydrofracking methods, they need 15 to 20 crore liter water along with more than 100 chemicals. The names of chemicals not put openly. At the same time, river sand they need for that, for single hydrofracking. At the time of hydrofracking, they pressurize the water. In Cauvery Delta, the shale formation is at the level of 10,000 feet. They put the vertical borewell on 10,000 feet and the horizontal borewell are lying for 2 or 3 kilometers. They pressure the hydrofracking liquid, which is already told, water plus chemical plus sand, with high pressure, like 15,000 psi, they pressure on that places. On the high pressure, it consolidates the gas or oil on the shale, that is the sedimentary rocks, they get it. After the hydrofracking method is finished, the flowback water, nearly 60 to 70% of water it is injected on the well, which is flowback to the surface. The method of treatment is very alarming. At the same time, it gives more environmental hazards. Some people ask me about that. The hydrofracking is going on USA. Why can't in European countries? They told that geographical area, that is the area in USA, is more than European countries. At the same time, population is less than European countries. They mentioned that. But fortunately or unfortunately, the Indian population is more than the European countries. The Indian geographical area is less than European countries. So, we compare this. Particularly, Cauvery Delta, it consists of very denser population and very, very much agreeable land. The barren land, as per record of government, is minimum 1 to 1.5% alone. But these are all the issues we faced here. If these unconventional projects are going on here, we affected not only in our fertile land, at the same time, the groundwater also affected. So, there are more vegetations are going on here. For example, we allow in these places, Cauvery Delta, if it is going on continuously, day by day, the total potential available here is only to exist of 50 years alone. But the agriculture going on here is for the past 2000 years. More than 1000 years, the project agriculture may be going on here on the basis of very distressed water, even though distressed water. So, we ask the central government to reconsider these projects in Cauvery Delta, because we are not against development. We are not against to oil exploration itself, but on which place it will deal. This is the more to fertile land. This is the food grain of Tamil Nadu. In particularly, 60 to 70% of paddy production is lying on this Cauvery Delta alone. So, we give importance to the agriculture rather than the petro products. So, we humbly request the central government to reconsider this project. This is the mind of Cauvery Delta people, so that they want to protect themselves. They want to save themselves. So only the agitations are going on here. Some people told that there are politicizing that, but even the ground level, there are so many people, they know about the project, they know about the hazards maybe happened here. So, we want to prevent our area, we want to prevent our agriculture, we want to prevent our groundwater, we want to prevent our drinking water itself.